Welcome. This is the Algebra 1 end of course practice test number 3, question number 18. What is the perimeter of the trapezoid A, B, C, D? It's a little tough to see the trapezoid. I'm going to try to do my best to sort of outline where the lines are. So it's sort of here, and then it goes down here, then it goes down here, and then it goes down here. So we've got this little trapezoid that we're dealing with. For most of the perimeter, it's pretty simple. You can just count. I mean, you can do the distance formula between them if you want to, but if they're straight lines that are going vertically or horizontally, why bother? Just count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So A to B is 16. It also helps if you know the perimeter is all the way around. So when somebody says, I'm going to check the perimeter, theoretically they should be walking all the way around the structure so they get the whole perimeter. From here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which you could have gotten by negative 4 minus 1 if you want to. Either way, I'm kind of a choose-your-own-adventure type as far as that's concerned. The next set, C to D. This is supposed to be B to C. It looked like B to E, but it wasn't. I wasn't attempting that. It was just terribly drawn. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. So far, I'm dealing with... I'm still going to have to do my A to D thing, and that's where the part of the problem that they want to get you on comes in. But so far, I have 9 and 6, which would be 17, so 27. No, 25. I don't know what I was thinking. 9 and 6 is 15. I'm crazy. 25 so far. So now I have to add A to D. And I'm going to clean this out a little bit just so you can sort of see where it's all going. So for this part, there's a couple ways that you can do it. You're welcome to go back to the formulas page and use the distance formula. I don't have tons of interest in doing that because I know that the distance formula is based off of the Pythagorean theorem, which is much easier to write for me anyway. So I'm going to make my own little triangle here. Pythagorean theorem is a squared plus b squared equals c squared. If you look at the distance formula, that, you know, whole x of 2 minus x of 1 thing, it's pretty much the Pythagorean theorem. It's just written as the sides being it's showing you the endpoints as opposed to the distance of the full side. But I can count that, so that's way easier. For me, here's my right angle. I tend to have my students touch the right angle to identify A and B, A side and B side. So here's A side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So 12 squared plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 squared equals C squared. Now from here, what I want to do is add my 12 squared, or 144, and then I want to add my 5 squared, which is 25, of course, and I end up with 169. And from the final step, of course, in any Pythagorean theorem is I need to take that square root to find the actual side. So 13. That's the side for AD. What they used to want to get you on is they would have 13 as one of the answers, but they're nice this time. So 25 plus 13 gives you a final answer of 38. So your answer to number 18 is B. Let's think outside of that problem for just one second. I'm going to go away from ever even doing the Pythagorean theorem. Let's just think logically. You know, based on just being able to count, that AB is worth 16, or the distance of it is 16. We know that BC is 5 and CD is 4. The distance from here to here cannot be significantly longer than 16. So if you add 25 and 16 together, you get 41, which is pretty close to 38 anyway. You know it's not 33 because you'd only be adding about 8 to it to get to 33. So that's pretty low. And you could tell right now that if this is 5, there's no way that this is just 8. It has to be at least double it. So this is probably not it. 50 is gigantic. You'd be adding 25 more. So that would be saying that this distance is the same as this plus this plus this, which obviously it's not. And 80 is crazy. So just think logically a little bit, and you could probably get to the answer or at least eliminate down to 2 without having to do Pythagorean theorem. Not that the Pythagorean theorem in this situation is particularly difficult. So there it is.